I'm Don Pettit. I'm one of the lucky ones that get to fly into space. I'm a NASA astronaut, and I've had the good fortune to have flown 3 times to the International Space Station. I've spent a total of over a year living on the International Space Station. I'd like to talk a bit about crew resource management, also known as CRM. This is something that the aviation industry uses extensively with flight crews to make sure that pilots don't make a mistake while they're flying an airplane, particularly during heavy workload environments like takeoff and landings. We use CRM on spacecraft as well. The space shuttle, for example, is a heavy CRM, almost CRM on steroid kind of environment, just due to the complexity of the machine and having a crew of 7 people working together to make sure that you fly it as expertly as you possibly can. Well, we don't have the shuttle anymore. It's retired. We're flying on the Russian Soyuz vehicles, and they use a different style of CRM. By the time we get our next American-made spacecraft completed, we may not have U.S. astronauts that have had experience flying in a U.S. spacecraft. And just as an example, now the astronaut corps is down to a little over 40 active astronauts. Only 6 or 7 are remaining that have flown on the space shuttle as a commander or a pilot. And the commander and the pilot are the ones that set the whole mood of how the CRM occurs with the rest of the crew. So we could very well reach a point where we no longer have any U.S. commander pilot flight experience when it comes time for us to fly our next spacecraft. And this is important from a CRM point of view, how the crew works together, how you correct each other when you make mistakes, and every crew makes mistakes, and the CRM process where the crew working together can keep the mistakes from becoming significant. And it's just one of my concerns for the future of our space program. CRM is something that takes more than just reading a book and then starting in and using it. CRM is developed. It's a skill that is ephemeral. You need to practice, and you need to provide an environment where crews can continue to practice their CRM skills. And if you don't have a spacecraft, you could do this in simulators, or you could do it in other analog high-intensive work environments, for example, flying T-38s, which is what we do in the astronaut office. So it's going to be important to try to nurture your CRM skills. And by the way, CRM skills in a spacecraft, they're like aviation CRM skills on steroids, particularly because the consequences of a crew-borne mistake can be really, really serious in a spacecraft, and the way we practice the CRM is different, although similar to the CRM in aviation. So if you're looking at the future and how you manage your assets, you want to keep and retain the knowledge of flying spacecraft, and in the core of people that you have for training to fly spacecraft that are yet to be developed or in the process of being developed, you need to provide the facilities so that they could continue to practice these volatile skills.